I hope you all are good. Today we will study our next topic, that is social insects. Some insects live on their own and others live in the groups. So the ants and honeybees are the social insects found in our environment. Let's talk about them one by one. First is ants. In an ant colony, there is a queen ant only who lays eggs along with the male ant who do not work, and female worker ants who do not lay eggs. We found ants in the open areas like garden, parks, etc., and even at our homes. Ants work together to keep the colony running by caring for the eggs and young ants, bringing in food and doing other jobs. There are at least two or three generations of ants who live in the same colony. Ant colonies also have a queen, female workers and male ants. Another social insect is honeybee, which is similar to the ant family. The queens are the most important member of the honeybee family. The queen's main job is to lay eggs. The workers are female and are kept very busy. The male or drone have no function. Worker bees collect nectar and pollen from the flowers. The bee turns this nectar and pollen into the sweet honey, which is stored in a special cells. So they both are the social insects. Now let's talk about some harmful insects. Some insects such as mosquitoes are very harmful because they transmit diseases. Some insects like locust damage our crops and gardens. Some insects like termites damage our furniture. Some insects like clock moth destroys our clothes by making holes in them. Bees and wasps sting humans and animals. A bee sting is very painful. Ants and cockroaches spoil our food and spread diseases causing germs. Lice live on our heads and survive by sucking blood from our scalp. Houseflies sit on the garbage and dirt, and then they sit on the food. If we consume that food, it makes us sick. So these are some insects, harmful insects, which causes various diseases. Now, if sometime an insect bites a human being, so what precautions we can take? So our topic is cure for insect bites. First is, we should place a ice pack on the area for about 10 minutes at a time, so that it helps in reduction of pain and swelling. Then we should apply calamine lotion or a paste of baking soda and water to the area several times a day, so that it helps in relieving the itching and the pain. Then we should not pinch the stinger with the fingers or tweezers, as that can inject more venom. So these are some cure and insect bites the humans. Now here are some precautions that can help us preventing diseases spread by insects. So what should we do? We must cover our food at homes. We must not throw food in the open, but rather dispose them in dustbin. We must not let water stagnate, or we should not collect water at one place for a very long period of time. We should be very careful to keep our surroundings clean. We should use mosquito net or a repellent to keep mosquitoes away. We should wear clothes that properly covers our body. This will protect us from the insect bites and mosquitoes. If a bee stings, means if a bee bites a human, then we should consult to a doctor immediately. So these are some precautions that we should take. So with this, we have completed our chapter. If you have any queries, you can ask me. Thank you.